Hey, so welcome back to the shop, friends. So I'll be the first to admit, I love all these new power tools and all this new technology that's available to us now. So even with all the technology available to us, there's still three reasons that I know of that you must have a hand plane. Stick around to the end of the video, I have something I need from you guys. The first reason is texturing. Texturing wood with a hand plane leaves a surface that is so smooth, it's hard to explain. I use a number 4 Stanley Sweetheart plane for texturing. I have it set where it's taking very, very thin shavings. Video is just not gonna do it justice as to how smooth this board is after running the hand plane across it a few times. When you use a hand plane to smooth your projects, it leaves this texture that can't be obtained with sandpaper. It's so smooth. The other reason I like it is it leaves these subtle, very subtle imperfections in the wood. That subtle texture to the wood, those subtle imperfections, really creates that handmade appearance. I think moving forward, I'm gonna use my hand plane to texture all my projects, to leave those subtle imperfections and that smooth texture that you can obtain with the power tool. The second reason I think you need a hand plane is to chamfer the edges of the wood. I use a block plane, a Stanley block plane, to chamfer the edges of my projects. And sure, you can do this with a router, but a hand plane just leaves subtle irregularities that makes it look handmade and not machine made. To do this, you won't need an expensive block plane. You probably can get one at an antique store for $20 or $30 and sharpen the blade and it should be just fine. I love that 45 degree chamfer that the block plane leaves. If you've ever chamfered the edge of a board with a router, it oftentimes leaves a mark and then you have to go back and sand that out. And that's another reason that I prefer the block plane. The third reason you must have a hand plane if you're a hobby woodworker is flattening large surfaces. Let's take, for example, my workbench. There's no way that I could take my workbench apart and run it through a planer. So I'll have to do it with a hand plane. Now for flattening something big like this, I'll probably use my number 7 Stanley Bailey joiner plane. It could also be done with a smaller plane as well if you only have one. I'm gonna give you a bonus reason that I think that you need a hand plane in your wood shop. It's just fun to use them. This is what was used hundreds and hundreds of years ago. They make a great sound against the wood. You don't have to wear all that safety gear. They're just fun to use. So I said I needed something from you guys. Here's what I need. I think in order for this video to be super helpful for everyone, I wanna hear why you think hand planes are essential in a hobby woodworker's shop. Put those in the comments. That way we can all learn and benefit from that. If you like this video about hand planes, I know you're gonna like this one. So check that one out and I'll see you over there.